India is a place where we have a huge multitude of population, and as we know, land is scarce. And not just scarce, but it has multiple uses. So land can be used for agriculture, it can be used for grazing, it can be used for industry, it can be used for settlements, and so on and so forth. And in today's day and age, land acquisition as such is becoming a more of a problem. In this context, we have a huge plan to do 100 gigawatts of solar power plants in India. Now, this would require huge tracts of land. Now, not just multiple uses, but land further kind of has other problems associated with it. One, there is to find a plain terrain which is shadow free is again a difficult proposition. You can find it in wastelands, but again, to convert those wastelands into power plants, one has to kind of do a lot of effort into making those areas plain. A floating power plant, on the other hand, does away with these disadvantages. So on a water body, you have a flat surface which is completely plain. It has no undulations. Secondly, it captures no dust from the atmosphere. Now, in case of solar power plants, one of the biggest enemies of a solar power plant, so to say, is the dust accumulation on the solar panels. Now, in case of water body, that dust accumulation does not occur. Thirdly, if you look at the current regional focus of solar power plants, we have most of our power plants in the western region of India. Now, western region of India also has very high temperatures. Now, there is a constant, or there is a relationship between temperature and how the solar panels function. Above 25 degrees centigrade, which is the operating temperature of a solar panel, every degree rise decreases the efficiency of the solar panel by almost 0.45 degrees percent. So let's say if you are operating at an ambient temperature of 45 degrees centigrade, you already are putting down your efficiency by 10%, and that too in a solar industry where your photovoltaic modules at maximum provide 20% efficiency. So in case of a water body, you have natural evaporative cooling that happens. So water evaporates, and which kind of cools the back of the solar panels. Now this kind of maintains an ambient temperature. So this can increase the efficiency of a floating solar power plant vis-a-vis a land-based solar power plant by almost 5 to 10 degrees centigrade. A floating solar power plant, the possibility of dual axis tracking that we have developed, that Yellow has developed, is a very cost-effective method to generate 30% more power. Now, conventionally, you place the modules according to the latitude of the place. They put it at an angle, south facing, according to the latitude of the place. Now, what does that mean? That means that only when the sun is in its peak, which is between, let's say, about 11 o'clock in the morning till about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, where the sun is south facing and the sun is at its maximum peak, does the power plant generate the most electricity. However, as virtue of the solar panels, if we are able to follow the sun, as the sun moves from east to west, or as the sun moves from horizon to zenith and back to the horizon, if we are able to follow the sun, we'll be able to generate more electricity, because we'll be able to increase the duration for which the solar rays are falling on the panels, and we'll also be able to maximize the peak. So the maximum solar insolation are absorbed or are taken into consideration when energy is being considered. So this in general provides almost about 20 to 25% extra efficiency. Now, in case of a floating solar power plant, the 10% extra efficiency comes from natural evaporative cooling. So both these put together, you can almost have about 30% extra energy generation. Since so a floating solar power plant or land neutral power plants are a new conception and are a new entity as of now, the cost till we get to a utility scale is it has not been established so far. Across the world, the cost varies from 10 crores to 12 crores per megawatt. What Yellow is trying to do is we are trying to put that cost to 8.5 crores to 9.5 crores per megawatt. That is depending on the site conditions, depending on what conditions we are working on. Apart from that, this price is justified from the fact that one is producing 30% more energy. So as compared to a land-based, which you can get at 7 crores and 8.5, or let's say even at 6 crores if you get a land-based power plant, at 8.5 you are producing that much extra energy to offset the capital cost of land-based solar power plant. So in the end, the unit cost of power, which is the ultimate commodity to a consumer, that can be stabilized in competition with land-based power plants. A 1 megawatt of power plant, the space requirement is almost similar to what would be required at land, which comes to approximately 12 square meters a kilowatt. Now, through our design, there are multiple possibilities. We can establish a 1 megawatt power plant in a block of 120 meters by 120 meters. Or if you kind of divide it into several of these smaller modules, then over 2.5 acres, one can easily establish a 1 megawatt power plant. The whole idea or conception of putting up a solar power plant was aeration of the lake, because past news stories have put that because of the decreasing BOD levels in the lake, a lot of fishes that are in the lake that are dying. Now with this putting up of this solar power plant and aerators, which is in our case, which are the fountains, one can increase the level of BOD. Hence, which gives a better chance of survival for the fishes in the lake.